say, no, I urge you to read it. It really is the most eclectic and moving, I think, collection. We've also got humor, we've got poetry. It's stunning. So I take very little credit, actually, for the fact that this book has become what it is, except for the fact that the initial idea was mine. The energies that kind of took over the project at Zuban, at Save the Children, and then just from the writers. My life has completely changed. I remember when I was pregnant, it was just so difficult, and I thought, why doesn't anybody tell you how difficult it is? And that's one thing I've realized, that women for some reason don't really share their struggles and how difficult things are. It's like, oh, you have a child, oh, you're pregnant, oh, great news, congratulations, everything is so happy. Then it's almost that you feel guilty complaining about it. But I think it is very, very difficult.
Number of women we lose due to pregnancy related issues in 1 week in India are more than in all of Europe in a whole year. The number of women we lose due to pregnancy related issues in 1 year is the same as having 400 airplane crashes a year. Can you imagine what would happen if that were to be the case? Governments would fall. But because it's poor rural women who are dying, we are pushing it into the sidelines. This state of affairs continues in spite of the Prime Minister having said that this is a case of national shame.
All have mothers, and probably there isn't a more intellectually challenging or consuming task that simultaneously also contributes to shaping our world as mothering our children. So we really need to bring that lens to bear on our society, think about our humanity in terms of the support we give as a society to mothers.
Our experience of publishing Mothers and Others has been totally wonderful. We worked with Save the Children Fund. We were a bunch of girls. We had the most amount of fun, and we really enjoyed putting together different writers and working with Jayashree, who's really energetic.